So today we speak to you about the open joining, that is a new feature that has been added to the stack in the last release. And after that, I will speak about the provisioning that is built on top of the open joining feature. And last, I will finish with our reference designs. Okay, so first, open joining is a new feature that has been introduced to the stack that allows a node to join a network, even if it has not the network parameters like the encryption keys or the network address. So a bit of terminology to help follow the next step of the presentation. What we call a new node is a node that wants to connect to a network, but that has not the network parameters. An existing node is a node that is already connected to the network and that will take part in the joining process. And the joining beacons are a new type of beacons that have been introduced to the Wirepass stack, and that is allow a node to join the network. So what happens when a node wants to join a network? First, it starts with the existing nodes in the network that can sense at regular interval joining beacons. Basically, what does these beacons is to tell old new nodes that they can join the network. And I want to stress that, but I say join and not connect, because joining is not exactly a connection. We'll see that after that. And these beacons can be controlled from the application, but they can also be controlled from the backend with the remote API, meaning that basically what you can do is turn on or off the joining capabilities directly from your backend and control that from the backend. And when a new node wants to join a network, it will scan for these beacons. And once it has received them, it will find in these beacons all the necessary information to join the network. So that's why I say join and not connect, because when you join the network, you are not really connected because you don't have the network parameter. In fact, you are just connected with a point-to-point connection to the existing node. And that means that when you send packets, you can only send them to the existing node. These packets are not routed in the network, and also they are not encrypted. That means that the existing node will have to act as a proxy, meaning that it will have to forward back and forth the received packet from the new node to the backend, and vice versa. When a backend responds, the existing node will have to forward them to the new node. So basically, this is the open joining feature, meaning that the new node that doesn't have the network parameters or encryption keys can temporarily join the network and connect to an existing node. And all the Wirepass provisioning is built on top of this feature, meaning that we have created a protocol that allows a new node to provision. All these specifications are available in the documentation for Wirepass licenses that is much more detailed than what I will tell you today. So basically, what is provisioning? Provisioning allows a new node to retrieve provisioning data from the backend system. And this provisioning data consists of all the network parameters, meaning the network address, the network channel, the encryption keys of the network. With this information, the node will be able to connect normally to the network. And optionally, specific application parameters from the application can be added to this provisioning data. And as I thought before, the link between the new node and the existing node is in plain text. So this provisioning data can be optionally encrypted. This slide describes in further detail the whole process of provisioning. So first, during production, new node is flashed with a unique ID and optionally a shard key. The unique ID, in fact, is used by the provisioning server to identify this node. And the shared key, as its name is shared between the new node and the provisioning server, can be used to encrypt the provisioning data. So, as I said, joining beacons are controlled by the existing node. So first, to be able for a node to provision, some nodes or all the nodes in the network must broadcast joining beacons. And when the new node will want to provision, it will scan for this beacon and join the network. Once it has joined the network, it will send a request, a provisioning request with its unique ID to the existing node. And this packet will be automatically forwarded by the stack to the provisioning server. That means that there is no special application needed in the existing node. All happens in the stack. And when the provisioning server receives this provisioning request, it will compare the unique ID received with what it has in its database. And if the node is authorized to be provisioned, the provisioning server will reply with the provisioning data. And the packets follow the same path in opposite direction, meaning that it reaches the existing node, and the existing node will forward it automatically to the new node. And on reception of this provisioning packet, the new node will decrypt it if it's encrypted and apply the network parameters. And after a reboot, the new node, as it has now all the network parameters, will be able to connect normally to the network. This slide presents basically the same thing, but with the message flow between the new node and the provisioning server. So I will go quick on this. First, the new node joins the network, and after that, it sends a start packet, including the unique ID to the backend system. And I'll, as you see also there, the existing node is only there to forward back and forth the packets. And when the start packet is received by the backend system or the provisioning server, it will reply with a data packet, including the provisioning data. At this point, the new node will respond with an acknowledge and apply the network parameters to be able to connect to the network. So the protocol is quite simple, but nothing more than that is needed to do the provisioning. Okay, now a bit more about the software architecture. On the new node side, we developed the provisioning library that is a set of source files that runs inside the application and that will manage all the provisioning parts. As you see on the existing node, there is also some provisioning library that is a set of helper functions to enable and disable the joining beacons. But this is totally optional because that can be managed directly from the backend. And on the backend side, we developed the provisioning server that is built on top of our backend client. So a bit more about the provisioning library. It's included in our SDK that is now available on GitHub. It implements the full provisioning protocol for the new nodes. And what is important is that it's fully automatic and runs in the background, meaning that you just have to initialize and start the provisioning library. And after that, the application has nothing else to do. also the behavior of the library can be customized with init structure during initialization, and you can also have some interaction by callbacks to follow what's happening during the provisioning process. And as this feature runs in background of the application, and as it can be quite complex to know what happens and to debug it, we have added some helper function to print debug logs on the serial port. And this will allow you to follow what's happening during the provisioning process during your development on your node. And of course, this is not enabled by default. And if you don't enable all the serial logs, it won't add any binary code to your application in the end. So it's really a development feature. So what about our reference designs? Right now, all our reference designs are available on GitHub. For the embedded part, it's in our WirePass Mesh SDK that Gwendal presented previously. And for the provisioning server, it's available inside the backend client repository. So on the embedded part, we offer first the provisioning library. All the source code is available inside the SDK, but also two test applications, one for the new node and one for the existing nodes. On the new node, basically what's important, if you have an example, how to store the unique ID and the shared keys. There is two examples. The most important is the one that shows you how to store this data in a dedicated memory area in the flash memory. And the usage is quite straightforward, meaning that if you want to start the provisioning, you just have to press a button and follow what's happening in the debug logs. The existing node application is optional because you can enable or disable joining beacons from the backend, but to start testing, it can be useful to have this application, as you can enable or disable the beacons just by pressing a button. And finally, for the provisioning server, as I said, everything is available in the backend client repository. Once you have installed the backend client, you have nothing more to do. It's installed at the same time. And if you click on the link below, you will have example configuration files, meaning that you can customize, of course, to which MQTT broker, to which backend you will connect. But also you will have example how to add the unique ID of each node that will be accepted by the provisioning server, along all the provisioning data that you will need to send to them.